God's children to stand. Yeah.
Stand.
Tell somebody, say,
you stand.
Yeah, Lord, yeah. Stand for holiness.
For holiness.
Oh.
Stand for righteousness.
And be counted.
And be counted among them that shall reign with
some of my friends. And I would rather,
stand.
I'd rather live right, turn in hell, lift up my eyes. All of God's children, just stand. Stand.
Stand.
Everybody say to
you, stand.
Oh, stand for holiness.
Stand for holiness.
Good morning, good morning. Another week, I tell you. I mean, just as soon as you think you have something tied down, it gets all loose again. And it's been a heck of a week. So we're going to go ahead and get started. Standing in the gap with our revelation project. And as always, start out with prayer. Our Father and our God, we want to thank you, Father. You have brought us safely once again, Father, to the time where we're able to get together, Father, and study your word, Father. We just ask that you open our hearts and open our minds, Father, so that we can hear the truth, Father. And Father, it's just depressing, Father, sometimes to see those of us who just don't have an understanding, Father, just don't understand the word, and proceed as if they do. So, Father, we're asking you to make it clear to them, Father. Impress upon them, Father, the true nature of your word, Father, because they're getting further and further away from you, Father. And that gap is just expanding, Father. And we just need some people to come down and stand in the gap with us, Father, as we try to teach your true, unadulterated word, Father. Father, we ask you to bless all those who are taking the time, Father, to join us, Father, for a learning experience, Father. All those who are on the way, Father, we especially want you to bless all those who don't feel they need to know that they're safe and sufficient and satisfied with acting without the truth. So, Father, we thank you for that. In your name, for your sake, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Well, we're going to move on to our standing in the gap moment. And just so those who may be new or understand, standing in the gap is standing in the gap between God and us, meaning man and woman. And that gap between what God stands for and where we're headed and what we believe and what we think is right is widening, because people are not understanding God's word and don't even take the time to study it to understand it. And as Jesus says, that our people are destroyed by lack of knowledge. So that's what Standing in the Gap USA stands for. And every week I try to bring to the forefront a certain topic, and I call it a stand in the gap moment, which gives us a chance to understand that we need to stand in the gap on certain issues. And so that's what we're going to do today. And something that it's always, you have a plan And as to which way you want to go with something, you're thinking about, okay, for this week's stand in the gap moment, I'm thinking about doing this. But then something happens through the week whereby it diverts you to something else. And I had a discussion with a friend, went to Walnut Hills High School with me, and also with relatives. And, you know, you talk to people over time to try, and they want to talk about religion, they want to talk about God and all that. But this discussion that I had this time was very remarkable to me. You see, I found that there are different views, and obviously there are, by those claiming to be Christians. And a large part of the differences are based on a lack of knowledge or ignorance of the truth. You know, people get upset when you say ignorance, like that's a bad word. Ignorance is basically you don't know something, haven't been presented with something. So I don't use it as a insult, but just as a truth. You see, a large part of those who are claiming to be Christians and don't have the knowledge of the truth also believe in the teachings of the world. They don't believe in the teachings of God anymore, or they don't listen to it anymore as much as they listen to the teachings of the world. One view that when I talked to this friend of mine who I graduated or went to school with, he indicated that, and he's a Jewish fellow, and he was asking about, because he had watched one of the Stand in the Gap presentations, and he was asking me about believing in God. And he said, because he found that most people he talks to now do not believe in God. And which I found that surprising. And I told him, I said, well, that's surprising to me, because most people I do believe in God. They may not actually study it or understand. They believe in the concept of God. But he says that most people he talked to today's world, they don't believe in God. That was disturbing, because he was a Jewish fellow, but his mother was a Christian. And he got a brother who's a Messianic Jew, and Messianic Jews believe that Jesus is the Messiah. And he said, all right, I'm just hoping that there is a God. Okay. Now, another view is that some people believe, in talking to other people, that all religions are the same. All religions believe in the one God, and basically that means they believe in the same God. Well, and basically what that would mean is that God and Jesus, the Trinity or whatever, is the same as Allah. And that there's no difference between Christianity and Judaism, Islam, Hinduism, Buddhism, all those things. And some people believe that Catholicism is actually a separate religion from Christianity. And that there's no difference between Christians and Mormons. Christianity and Mormonism are no difference between Jehovah's Witnesses and Christianity. And once again, I state our people are destroyed by a lack of knowledge. And that's why we have to study. That's why we have standing in the gap. That's why you have to open the Bible and read it. That's why you have to have a type of study where you can have commentaries and you can understand a lot of things in the Bible. Because if you just read through it, you're not going to understand it. And like I say, a lot of people say, I've read the whole Bible from beginning to the end. And if you really quiz them on it, they know nothing, hardly anything, because you have to study. You have to study. And see, by the lack of knowledge, the gap between what God says and what we believe gets larger and larger. And the schemes of the devil seem to be advancing. The world, remember when the Bible talks about the world, they're actually talking about a demonic system. The world becomes our teacher. And as we talked about, the matrix becomes is a fake reality that's pulled down over our eyes. We believe all that rather than believing God, believing Jesus. And it's worse than what we realize, because we're actually being assaulted by persons who want to become our teachers. They haven't studied anything, but they want to become our teachers. And they want to do it because they're all involved in the world, in that demonic system. And because they want us to believe that there is no God, or that at least sow the seeds of doubt and say, you know, at least question whether there is a God. And all religions are the same. And, you know, people have a right to believe in what they want. And I agree with that. You have a right to believe in what you want. And but people say that if you disagree, then you're wrong for what you believe. And some people accuse me of just being old school. You're old school, you know. We're advanced in today's age, and we don't have to believe in all those things that have been around for 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 years. So you're just old school. And so what they want you to do is just believe and accept all views. Believe and accept all views. And believe and accept all who espouse these views. And that what that leads to then is us believing anything, falling for anything, and supporting anything. And like I said, it was this discussion with the person I went to school with some relatives and all that, about what I'm talking about here. And then certain things just happened, and it just came to my attention again, something that happened a few weeks ago. And can you...
from top religious leaders, this time for his trip to a Washington, D.C. shrine honoring St. John Paul II. Washington's Archbishop Wilton Gregory condemning the visit, saying, "I find it baffling and reprehensible that any Catholic facility would allow itself to be so egregiously misused and manipulated." Gregory also slamming the Trump administration's Monday crackdown on demonstrators to, quote, silence or scatter or intimidate them for a photo opportunity in front of St. John's Church, a block from the White House.
Senator McConnell, was what the president said last night the right thing to do?
Most Republicans silent on the issue, but this sharp take from the party's only African-American senator, Tim Scott.
Obviously, if your question is, should you use tear gas to clear a path so the president can go have a photo op, the answer is no.
The U.S. Park Police says their officers did not deploy tear gas at Lafayette Park, but acknowledge using smoke canisters and pepper balls that contain a chemical designed to irritate the eyes. And law enforcement officials tell NBC News Attorney General William Barr ordered officers on Monday afternoon to finish clearing protesters away from the park after learning about the president's plan. Defense Secretary Mark Esper, who posed with the president outside the church, telling NBC News he did not know where the president was leading them, and that he had no idea about the plan to use force to disperse protesters. After declaring himself the law and order president, President Trump praised himself for overwhelming force and domination on city streets, and then thanked himself. Former Vice President Joe Biden says the country is crying out for leadership.
Donald Trump has turned this country into a battlefield riven by old resentments and fresh fears.
Taking this swipe 24 hours after he took a knee before black faith leaders, while President Trump posed with a Bible.
I just wish he opened it once in a while, instead of brandishing it. If he opened it, he could have learned something.
While former President George W. Bush released a statement saying in part, "This is not the time for us to lecture, it's a time for us to listen. It is time for America to examine our tragic failures, and as we do, we will also see some of our redeeming strengths."
All right. Well, that really stuck with me. It was, I'm not sure what, I guess I am sure what the purpose of all that was. But I want to take you to 2 Timothy 3. I always want to root what I say in the Bible. See, because a lot of the things that you see and you're influenced by, you can just brush it off and not understand the effect that it has or how it relates to the Bible. And as we're talking about the end times, we're talking about Revelation. We're in chapter 21. There are only 22 chapters. We're almost at the end of it. So this kind of resonated with me. And, you know, we always talk about Revelation being not a departure from the other books of the Bible, but incorporates them. And so if you study, you'll find all around the Bible, you'll find references to the end times. Not just in Revelation, Old Testament, New Testament. We started out this study on Matthew 24. We didn't start in Revelation. We started Matthew 24 when Jesus was talking about the end times. And then I want to take you to Timothy. Now, Timothy was a young preacher, a follower of Paul. And the books, Timothy is Paul basically instructing and telling this young preacher about certain things. And by the time that he's talking to Timothy, he's talking about in 2 Timothy chapter 3, the end times. It starts out, "This know also that in the last days perilous times shall come." And this part really got to me. It said, "For men shall be lovers of their own selves." And you see, I've imposed this scripture on top of the president standing in front of St. John's with upside down Bible. So, "Men shall be lovers of themselves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers." It says incontinent. If you know what incontinent means, that's not good. "Fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God, having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof." And the last thing it says in this part of the scripture, it says, "From such, turn away." From such people, turn away. Have nothing to do with them. You say, if we didn't know the person upon whom this is superimposed, and we just drew a picture of somebody who does these things, it would look just like him. It would look just like him. Look at it. Lovers of themselves, boasters, proud, blaspheming, without natural affection, false accusers, despisers of those that are good. If you've been following the news this week, you'll see that Trump is so desperate in his bid to be reelected that he said that Joe Biden didn't believe in God. He's trying to hurt God.
He said he's trying to hurt the Bible and hurt God. How crazy does that sound?
And I saw one commentator say, "Well, I'll put my money on God in that in that battle, if that's the case." But for him to come out and say that, then he has to make trying to make himself be the opposite, right? That he is a person who loves God, that he is a person who is reads the Bible, loves the Bible, and all that kind of thing. And he's holding an upside down Bible. Mm-mm-mm. And he cleared the path to get over to stand in front of this church for this photo op by gassing and beating people who are legally and peacefully protesting. Now, then he wants you to look at this at this photo op, and I'm a man of God. Don't be fooled. Please don't be fooled by that. And understand that when somebody does something like that, refer back to Timothy, 2 Timothy 3. And you'll see a biography in this scripture of Donald Trump. Now, people say, you're getting political in this. No, I'm not. I'm standing in the gap. That's what I'm doing. I'm not buying it. I'm not letting somebody who is trying to make me think he has a form of godliness to tell me what to do and what I should believe and all that. I'm not following that. I'm not following that. Now, if you don't want to vote for Biden, that's up to you. Okay? But tell me one good reason why you, as a Christian person, doesn't see how Timothy, 2 Timothy 3, is basically a biography of Donald Trump. You know, believe what you want to believe, but don't do it in ignorance. And I relate back to what I said previously, is that we're destroyed because of ignorance. And so if you want to choose to go a certain route, at least have your eyes open and know that this is or the consequences is where it came from and all that kind of thing. Understand, you have a right to jump into the fiery lake if that's what you want to do, but understand what all that means. Make your own mind up now. And this is why I stand in the gap. To do away with ignorance that destroys us. I will make what I've done in my teachings is that I have certain subjects that I've taught. And I want to tell my friend that said that he's just trying to believe, hoping there is a God, that, you know, I have studies on. I have one. God is real. It's an in-depth study, and it speaks the truth about God. A lot of people don't believe in God, he says. Okay. Go to this study. I have one on the spirit world, and that's online. They can...
Right. The God is real is not online.
Right.
But part of the spirit, the whole spirit world curriculum, we didn't start doing the live and the filming until about halfway through it. Mm-hmm. But we always reviewed and mm-hmm. So if you watch the spirit world videos that are up on our YouTube channel, you'll be able to get a really good feel for what angels and demons and what happens with that particular curriculum.
Now, we do have the outlines.
They're not online.
They're not online yet, yeah. But we do. I do have the outline, so we'll be able to put those online, even though there's not the live broadcast. And we can do that for another Stand the Gap that I do is called The Cross and the Crescent, which compares Christianity and Islam. For you to have knowledge and not ignorance about that, I have on there also sex in the Bible. Now, some of these things are going to be, some people don't want to hear it. They don't want to hear the stance that I may take on these things. But you got to understand, I have to make my own stance, okay? I'm not going to listen to the world teach me what is right and what is wrong, because I know that's a demonic system. I have other studies, too, but those are the ones that that we need to focus on, and I will do something to bring those to your attention, those that are not on there, that are not online, so that we can know the truth. And bottom line, don't fall for this. Do not fall for that. This man standing up there with the Bible in front of the church, and you know his track record. Whether, you know, like Biden said, did he open it? And if he did, he would have seen that it was upside down.
Did you hear it? He calls 2 Corinthians 2 Corinthians.
Yes. Yeah. 2 Corinthians.
That sounds like two guys from Corinth to me.
All right. Well, that's a stand in the gap moment. And understand that I want you to, and when you get a chance, take time to read and meditate over 2 Timothy chapter 3.